Sparks fly today as the case against the local man accused of killing a Northern Kentucky mom heads back to court. A heated hearing centering around new DNA evidence that could clear David Dooley of murder.
And WLWT first broke this story. We were first to report DNA test showed evidence collected there at the scene did not match Dooley. Yeah,
but how that evidence was released to us turned into a nasty fight in court today. WLWT News 5's Brian Hamrick continues his coverage with tonight's big story.
Well, after the first round of DNA tests came back, David Dooley was in court here in Boone County today to ask for his bond to be lowered. But before the hearing was over, there were new allegations, these against his attorney. Accused killer David Dooley walks into court.
The Commonwealth of Kentucky versus David Wayne Dooley.
And into a DNA debate.
David Dooley, 4874.
All after investigators' first round of DNA tests failed to link him to the murder of Michelle Mockby.
And based upon that DNA report, you're holding an innocent man.
Dooley's attorney, Eric Deters, told Judge J.R. Schrand, in light of the test, bond should be lowered and Dooley should be put on house arrest.
I'm unaware of any case like this where somebody is charged with such a serious offense and a high-profile crime where there's it's incredible, the lack of evidence.
But Commonwealth Attorney Linda Talley Smith says only three lab reports have come back so far.
Only one deals with DNA, and it was 14 samples from 123 items held in evidence. Some of those were multiple swabs from the same items.
Meanwhile, the Commonwealth says Deters violated a court order. Talley Smith filed a contempt charge saying Deters provided too much information about the case online, in social media, and to the press. She's specifically angry about our exclusive story, including the DNA and reaction from Dooley's wife, Janet.
It would be unfair for this case to be moved out of Boone County because of pretrial publicity.
And the judge wants to see both sides back in court here June 12th. Brian Hamrick, WLWT. News 5.